This is a 2017 question paper for 14 marks. Okay. Please write in your book. And you can easily understand when I am solving on the board. Okay. Guys, this is a 2017 14 marks question. Yes, 2017 14 marks question. As usual, I read the question and please make a point of each and every point. Following are the summarized balance sheets of Uma Company Limited on 31st of December 2015. And 31st December 2016 is given 2 years information. Now, as I told you, first we have to read one after one point so that we can easily understand. Okay, first liability side will finish it off, then we'll go to the things. See, whichever the point you read, we have to read the adjustment, whether do we have any adjustment related to that account or not. Equity share capital, do we have any adjustment for equity share capital? Absolutely, there is no adjustment for the equity share capital, but there is an increase in the working capital compared to 2015. In 2016, there is an increase of 50,000 rupees. That means to say, during the year, we have issued 50,000 rupees of share capital to the public. So therefore, I will write it directly in the issue of share capital, 50,000 rupees in funds flow statement. See, what are the items which comes in the funds flow statement is only preference share equity capital, preference capital, mortgage loan, debentures, long term loan, only these four items will come down. Okay, understood? Okay, fine. Next, 10% preference share capital. We'll see, is there any adjustment for preference share capital? Absolutely, there is no adjustment for preference share capital. But there is a decrease in the preference share capital. It becomes 40,000 to 25,000. There is a redemption of 15,000 rupees of preference share capital. So when you redeem, cash is going out, funds is going out, redemption of preference share capital of 15,000 rupees. So there ends with the preference share capital. Capital reserve is showing 10,000 rupees. See, capital reserve, there is an increase in the share, capital reserve. From where we got the capital reserve, if you look at the adjustment number 1, you will get to know. Okay? A piece of land has been sold in 2016 and profit on sale being credited to capital reserve. That means, we sold some land and building and we got some profit by selling the land and building. That profit of rupees 10,000, whatever is shown in the balance sheet, the liability side capital reserve, that capital reserve, how did we got it? That is a profit on sale of land and building. Let's check with a small account of land and building account. See, the opening balance of land and building, is 62,500, right? And closing balance is 42,500. And what he is telling is, there is a decrease in the value of the land and building. See, it becomes 62,500 to 42,500. That means, there is a decrease of 20,000 rupees of land and building. What it means, we have sold 20,000 rupees of land and building. But when you are selling this land and building, when you are selling this land and building, you made a profit of 10,000 rupees. That means you sold for 30,000. Therefore, what I write here is adjusted profit and loss account. Profit on sale is 10,000. That means 20,000 rupees of land and building, you sold it for 30,000 rupees. 72,500 minus 42,500 is 30,000 rupees. This is by bank account sale balancing figure. See, if there is any profit on sale of any asset, we write it in the credit side of adjusted profit and loss account. Profit on sale of land and building is 10,000, and there is a sale of land and building of 30,000 rupees. So that means this and this, and this adjustment with this adjustment, we are clear. Okay, now we have done with the capital reserve liability side and also adjustment number 1, we have finished it off. Now let us see general reserve 15,000 and 20,000. There is an increase of 5,000 rupees. So therefore, first I will write it here, transfer to general reserve as 5,000 rupees. Next, profit and loss account, opening balance of profit and loss account is 13,000, and closing balance of profit and loss account is 17,500. There ends the profit and loss account. And we have a liabilities, current liabilities of sundry credit cards, bills payable, outstanding expense. Sir, already we have taken these 3 and we have prepared statement of showing changes in working capital. Sundry credit cards opening is 15,000, closing is 29,000. Always current liability increases, there is a decrease in the working capital. Here there is a decrease in current liability, we write in the increase column. Here also decrease, we write it in the increase column. Got it? So we have done with this. But sir, what about this proposed dividend and provision for taxation? If you read the last paragraph of the problem, treating the proposed dividend and provision for tax as a non-current liability. See, if it is treated as a current liability, we would have taken in the current liability. But what he is telling, treat the proposed dividend and provision for taxation as a non-current liability. That means it is not a current liability. Then what we have to do, if it is a non-current liability, we have to prepare an account for that. Now, I will write it here, proposed dividend account. See, proposed dividend showing in the liability side, opening balance of proposed dividend is 15,000 and closing balance of proposed dividend showing 20,000. What is the meaning of, this is 21,000. What is the meaning of proposed dividend? See, last year, we declared dividends of 15,000 rupees. We have proposed the dividend for 15,000, which is not yet paid, but which is paid in the current year. To bank account, dividend paid. That is 15,000. Now, this year, we are keeping it off 36,000. 21,000. This is what from the current year profit we have made proposed dividend for the current year is 21,000. Now in adjusted profit and loss account, here we will write it as proposed dividend of 21,000, and in the funds flow statement, dividend paid as 15,000 rupees. Okay, bank account, dividends paid, adjusted profit and loss account, written it as a provision for taxation. Similarly, we write provision for taxation account also. Provision for tax account. What is this provision for tax? Again, this is a liability. Opening balance, I'll write it as 16,000 and closing balance as 18,000. Last year provision is paid in this year. This I'll write it as a tax paid as 16,000 and total becomes 34 and 34. That means last year dividend paid this year. This year dividend we have to pay in the next year. For that purpose, we are keeping some amount appropriate, reserve as a provision for taxation. This is provision made. This will be the balancing figure. Now, tax paid should be taken the 16,000 and provision for tax as 18,000 rupees. So we have done with the liability side as well as the last paragraph, whatever is given in the note. Now come to the asset side. Goodwill 30,000 to 27,500. There is a decrease in the value of the goodwill. We write here goodwill written off 2,500 rupees. There is a decrease in the goodwill of 2,500. Now land and building. Already we prepared an account for land and building and we have entered everywhere in the things. Plant and machinery. Please check with, do we have any adjustment for plant and machinery? We have two adjustments. How many adjustments? We have two adjustments. Let us see what we have to do for this. See, plant and machinery account. Now, opening balance of plant and machinery is 60,000 and closing balance of plant and machinery is 1,12,500. Okay, now what is the first, second adjustment says is depreciation on plant and machinery is 12,000 and no depreciation is charged on land and building, that is there. Now let us write adjusted profit and loss account. Depreciation on plant and machinery is 12,000 rupees. Okay, 12,000 rupees. Next, a machinery was third adjustment. A machinery was sold for 8,000, written down value being 10,000. That means 10,000 rupees of machinery, we sold it for how much? 8,000, and there is a loss of 2,000 rupees. So now I'll write it here. To bank account, sale, we sold it for 8,000 rupees and we incurred a loss of 2,000 rupees. Adjusted profit and loss account, loss on sale is 2,000. That's all about the machinery account. Now, check the total. Scribe side is more. 2 plus 2, 10, 14, 1 carries 3, 1,34,000. 500, 4, 7. This is called as to bank account purchases. Now, purchases always comes in the application 74,500. At the same time, depreciation on plant and machinery is 12,000. And loss on sale of plant and machinery 2,000 also will show. That's about the land and plant and machinery. Now in the balance sheet there is one more point. Furniture 7,500 to 6,000. If you read the third adjustment, no furniture has been sold. See, there is a decrease in the value of the furniture 7,500 to 6,000. That means 1,500 rupees of furniture is decreased. And he is clearly saying that if there is a decrease, it is not a sale. If it is not a sale, definitely it would be what? Depreciation only. So therefore, depreciation on plant and furnitures and fixtures is 1,500 rupees. So furniture part is also over. Next, what is that? Trade investments is a current asset. See, if it is a long term investment, then we'll show it whether there is a decrease in the investment, we'll take it as a sale. If there is an increase in the investment, we'll show it as a purchases. But this is what type of investment? Trade investment. It is a current asset. We have shown that sundry, debtors, store, BR, cash in hand, cash at bank, all these are all current assets. And if there is a increase, we write it in the increase column. If there is a decrease, we write it in the decrease column. That's we have done. And finally, we got there is an increase in the working capital of 36,500. Now, after that, in the balance sheet, we have preliminary expenses 7,500 to 5,000. There is a decrease of 2,500. So, therefore, I write it here as preliminary expenses written off 2,500 rupees. That's end of the balance sheet. Now one after one adjustment. First adjustment, piece of land is done. Done. Okay. Depreciation written off, we are done with plant and machinery. Machinery also we have showed. And an interim dividend of 10,000 paid during the year 2016. So now I will show it as closing matters. Interim dividend paid. Interim dividend is 10,000 is paid. At the same time, here we will write interim dividend paid of 10,000. So there is a dividend here also. See, this is a final dividend. This is a final dividend. This is a interim dividend. What is interim dividend? Dividend paid in between 2 years. That is 6 months on whatever the dividend you pay. That's called as an interim dividend. And the last adjustment, 1,500 has been received. See, 1,500 has been received. Received is nothing but what? Income or trade investment. So therefore, interest on investment is 1,500. When you are receiving any income, it is a source. Therefore, interest on investment is 1,500. So we are done with all the adjustments. Okay, done with all the adjustments. Now what we have to show is, we have to show increase in the working capital. Increase in the working capital of 36,500. Now we will find out funds from operation. 5, 10, 15, 20. Who carries 9? 10, 14, 16, 18, 26, 27, 32, 5, 6, 7, 9. 92,000. 10 one carries, 5 plus 7, 12, 1 carries, 6. This is called as funds from operation. Funds from operation always should be taken in the sources, 67,500. Now check with the totals of the funds from funds flow statement. 10 1 carries 9 14, 1,49,000. This is 10 1 carries 7 11 17 27 2 carries 9. So the problem is got solved with only one small correction. That is, when the land and building was sold for a profit of 10,000, which has been transferred to capital reserve, which we have already taken the capital reserve of land and building. Yeah? So earlier we have shown as an adjusted profit and loss account. It is not correct. See, capital reserve of 10,000 rupees, which is already showing in the balance sheet. So there will be no entry in the adjusted profit and loss account. That is how we get 92,000. Minus 14,500, will get 77,500 of funds from operation, and it sides with 1,67,000. Please guys, if you have any question, so please make this is a very important point. When there is a profit on sale of a land and building, the profit which you have already transferred to capital reserve, which is already in the balance sheet, so there is no need of showing the adjusted profit and loss. Okay. That's about, and the sale of plant and machinery 8,000 rupees, we should take it here. Okay? guts and the 2017. Please subscribe. Sai Srinath.